Dr. Terry Madonna, Franklin Marshall pollster, political analyst. He is the host of Pennsylvania Newsmakers. He's an author, a columnist, an all-around swell guy. He is Terry Madonna, and he joins us here on WSBA. Good morning, Terry. How are you doing?
Good morning, Gary. Well, I'm waiting for a real spring to come.
Yeah, cut the wind down. Somebody turn off the wind tunnel, please.
I played
36 holes yesterday, Terry. And
are you serious?
Wind was howling, and I could have played 54 had I not run out of light. Yeah, I was ready to play another 18.
Wind.
Oh, I loved it. Yeah, I just loved it. It was fun. The wind is challenging, but I had a great time, and I was taking in nature and communing with
good
nature. I was like Grizzly Adams. I was out there, you know, wrestling with the birds. On the 18th hole overlooking our course, there is a nest of eagles about 30 feet above the ground, and they have babies in there. And the mom and dad and the babies were out last night doing a full-time, you know, picture circus. I mean, they were out on the limb, and it was really cool to see. I mean, it's right above our 18th hole, and I wish they, you know, cut the squawking down a little bit when I'm trying to putt. But other than that, it was all good. So,
good for you.
Anyway, let's see. We're starting to get back into politics a little bit. We hear a little bit of the political stuff. And one of the things that you're hearing more and more of and seeing articles, Terry, and again, I think putting politics into COVID-19 is obscene. So I will preface everything I'm going to say by saying that from my standpoint. But you can't help as you do your homework for these kind of things, and you do that every day too, seeing the articles that are written and said, hey, blue state governors are holding up this stuff because they want to make sure that the economy stays trashed, all right, so that Trump doesn't get reelected in November. Now, to me, that's obscene to even think about that, and I'm not laying that out to anybody. But, you know, in a day and age where you and I have talked about it, we are polarized in this country by politics. We were that way before the COVID-19. Those questions are arising the longer we go into this whole thing. Your thoughts about that?
Well, look, I think, as you know, from votes in Congress and votes in state legislatures and Pennsylvania, let's include it, Democrats and Republicans, I think have genuine, real differences about how they want to approach this.
Yep.
I agree with you. I mean, can you rule politics out completely? Of course you can. But I think in the main there's a huge, huge, I'll call it a philosophic difference, but it's also a difference in reality, and Democrats have continually, as Governor Wolf has stressed, health, 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 health. And Republicans, given the business connections that many Republicans have been more responsive to the calls for opening up the economy. And you see that literally in every day. And by the way, you see it in the polls.
Yeah.
Democratic voters, much less likely to want to see the economy opened as quickly as Republican voters. And in some respects, what Democratic leaders are doing at all levels, at Congress, state legislature, county level, are literally responding to their voters.
But you know, it comes back to a basic
show that.
It comes back to a basic premise, though, that does get, and again, it's more philosophical, but it blends into political too, which is Democrats count on the government to solve problems. And Republicans say, we count on ourselves to solve problems. I mean, that's kind of what it comes down to at the end, that, government has a role to play, and yet how far do they go? So, you know, with Democrats, they say, okay, we're listening to the government now. For a lot of other Republicans, and especially right now in the era of Trump, where Trump says, hey, you know, government's a swamp, forget that, we go to our own devices. So you have that philosophical difference maybe even beneath that, which I think you just so aptly described.
Yeah, but remember, I agree, but there's another aspect to this, and we have 3.5 stimulus bills passed by Congress that were bipartisan. Now, the latest bill, the $3 trillion promoted by Nancy Pelosi, obviously isn't going anywhere, but it's my understanding that they're sitting down and they're meeting again and that there are things they do agree on, providing more money for state and local governments, providing money to hospitals, providing money to the schools.
Yep.
And so, you know, when push comes to shove on the several trillion dollars in stimulus that has already been passed and is working its way through the economy, there has been general agreement. I think it's more the speed with which it gets open that's the issue.
Well, and I think a lot of people are saying, you know, come November 4th, are we going to all of a sudden say, oh my gosh, you know, we're out of this? And, you know, I hope that's not the way it's being played. And again, there are those questions that are being raised out there. I guess I want to, you know, one of the things you were talking about, Governor Wolf. Governor Wolf has obviously come under some attack here in the last couple of weeks, especially the longer we've gone into this. And, you know, familiarity breeds contempt. You know, he's said, hey, this is the way I'm going to do it. This is the way I'm going to do it. But go ahead.
Hold on a second. But in every single poll that gets done, and we're not talking about party polls, his job performance is in the high 60s and low 70s.
I see that.
And in general, governors score higher in their job performance and in terms of handling the coronavirus crisis than President Trump. Although what's fascinating is that President Trump's job performance has actually gone up a bit. It's 45-46% positive, and you know, that's close to his all-time high.
Right.
Which on the Real Clear Politics average, I think, was 47%. And I'm talking about the average, you know, polls, you know, mm-hmm. different results. And what's fascinating about it is, and I think I mentioned this last week, on handling the coronavirus, 3-4 weeks ago, he was above 50%. And now he's about 42-43%.
Right.
Handling the crisis, he scores lower than his job performance. But here's the kicker. Yesterday, when I looked, his Real Clear Politics average for handling the economy is above 50%. Think about that for a minute. We're in, either you want to, you know, some economists say we're already in a depression. Others say we're obviously in a recession. And yet, handling the economy, I don't think the voters blame the president. Now, there's big differences by party again.
Sure.
You know, as
absolutely
we talked about before.
Well, you know what's always amazing to me, though, too, and the media gets their hands on this, and they'll say, oh, my gosh, look at the numbers went down during April. And you're thinking, we just turned the switch off willingly on our economy that was running great guns, and all of a sudden you're looking at this like, oh, my gosh, I'm surprised. Why would you be surprised when we turned all this stuff off? I mean, it's like turning the lights off in a room and being surprised it's dark. Yeah,
I
so
mean, you're, what, 16? Unemployment is, what, 16%?
Yeah, 16%.
Some think it will get to 25%, which is what we had at the height of the Great Depression. And, you know, now parts of the economy are beginning to open. And, you know, just watching some of the cable stations, there's some growing optimism that if the economy gets open, the you know, we may be at the depth of the recession. Well, you know, who knows for sure? And there are, and the president is the biggest cheerleader for the growth of the economy, saying fourth quarter, and in the next year we'll be even stronger than we were at the height of the
pre-pandemic. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, and we'll have to wait and see that. I think there's still a lot of changes that are going to come out of this, and I think we may come out of this leaner and meaner. I don't know. Dr. Terry Madonna with us this morning, Franklin, a Marshall pollster. Terry, you know, one of the things that you mentioned about the governor's ratings, and generally governor's ratings around the country have been pretty good for most states, be they Republican or Democrat, I might add. I know I saw in New York Cuomo getting like a 77% rating, where before the COVID-19 started, I think it was like, not very high. But one of the things that I look at with the governor, and I know talking to our delegation here has been fairly critical of the governor, and even our Democratic member of the delegation said this last week in an interview, that they think it's time for the governor to consult more with the state legislature, that as this thing has gone on, that this idea of we've concentrated the power in the hands of one branch of government is probably not where we should be now, and that the governor would serve himself and the people of Pennsylvania well if he were to involve the legislature more, and it does not look like he's doing that at this particular point. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, he's had several vetoes, you know.
Two days ago, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And I think you're right. I think it would be more helpful if they would sit down and try to reach out an agreement. But again, we have this huge philosophic difference that, as we talked about before, the Democratic governors and or Republican governors have with their legislature, depending on which party controls it. You're absolutely right about that. And I don't see it getting better anytime soon. I mean, look. Governor is slowly, if I got this correctly, I think real estate is now open, or will be open.
Right.
And I think, no, he's going to open up the economy. There isn't any doubt about it. He's just doing it.
Well, let me just insert one thing there, Terry, before you go on. on that. The real estate is a great example because they were talking about, was it real estate a couple days ago? And in the morning, and this was right from one of the senators yesterday, Senator Phillips Hill, said in the morning, they said, why can't real estate reopen? And the note that came from Dr. Levine's office was, and Dr. Levine herself said, die if we open those up in red areas. 4 hours later, the governor comes out and says, we're going to open that up. And so, what happens in 4 hours
under pressure.
Exactly. But the point being, if you involve the legislature who have direct lines to the people, and a lot of people think the governor is kind of insulated a little bit right now. If you do that, don't you get people now believing in what you're doing totally? I mean, you want to get everybody coming aboard, not just 70% or 67%, but everybody coming aboard and saying, oh, okay, well, that makes sense now. We're getting a lot more people involved in the decision-making. Your thoughts?
Yeah, well, you're absolutely, but here's the problem. If you go where Democrats come from, their voters are much less likely to want to open up the economy and be concerned more about health. And similarly, you go to Republican areas, you see the converse. I mean, yeah. Back to this issue, lawmakers on both sides are reflecting the views of their constituents.
Yes.
I mean,
yeah.
Not all of them. You know what I mean.
No, I have you.
Certainly a majority of them, and that's not likely to change.
And then you get the urban and rural dynamic being played in there as well.
Absolutely. I mean, there are parts of the economy, and what do we have now? 49 counties in Pennsylvania out of 67 that are in some phase of the opening,
mm-hmm.
meaning they've moved from red to yellow or will move, I guess, and I guess we're going to hear shortly in the next couple of days opening up other counties. So it's taking place. It's the speed with which it's taking place.
That's the question.
And secondly, what businesses are allowed to open?
Right.
I mean, I think we'd all have much more concerns about restaurants and bars, and even there, the proprietors that are and businesses, a lot of these small restaurant shops are not going to reopen, Gary. They're done.
Yeah, they are.
We're going to have a lot of folks that file for bankruptcy and literally go out of business. But there's some that are more natural in terms of the spacing that can be done. But it looks like in places where they've already opened it in other states, people are flocking.
Yeah.
Are flocking to the down, back in to try to get some semblance of, and I'll use the right word, normality. Normalcy is not a word.
what's fascinating to me also, and sadly fascinating, I might add, you talked about a lot of businesses are going to be closing. A lot of small businesses. You're going to see that carnage all across the country in different places because of different situations. And those people, in some way, shape, or form, I think, are going to be blaming somebody. All right? They're going to be saying, all right, who handled this well and who didn't handle it well? And therein lies maybe one of the cruxes of this next election. It's easy to go blame Trump for everything. I lost socks the other day, and I blamed Trump for those. But the idea is, there's also going to be some finger-pointing around from the local level in terms of the states and so forth, and people are going to say, well, what happened here?
Yeah.
As people do an accounting, so to speak, before they go out to vote. That's going to be we have no idea where that's going to go at this particular point.
Well, the other question, and look, there isn't any doubt how politicians have handled the coronavirus is going to be the central
absolutely
issue this fall, and in connection to that will be the health of the economy. Where does the economy stand? Because we've talked about this before, mm-hmm. that when you've got a governor and or a president, particularly president, seeking reelection during a bad economy, that's a political death sentence.
Right.
Ask Jimmy Carter, ask George Herbert Walker Bush.
Right.
And, the fact of the matter is that those two elements, unless we have some other kind of crisis that emerges.
Well, but the only thing that I would disagree with you on here, and the uniqueness of this, is we've never had anything like this. We've turned it off. I mean, we voluntarily turned it off, and that becomes a factor that we don't really have any landscape for right now, although, historically, you're right on all the other thing, but this is altogether different, and it's going to remain to be seen how people view it.
No, I couldn't agree more, but we also have the situation that will go into the judgments that people make.
Oh, no question. No, I agree with you.
Look at the party differences are so enormous on these things, and the shift in job performance for President Trump, for example, Democrats a little less support, even though he didn't have much to start. And but you got independent voters that have dropped their support, which is why.
Right.
And then when it goes back up, as it has recently, you know, it's basically a few more independent voters sign on to him for doing a positive job performance. But I'm still sort of shocked that in the Real Clear Politics average, a majority of the voters think on the economy that they got Trump, what, 51-52%
positive. Which is interesting, because that may also say, address the question I had earlier, and again, I don't know if this is the case. I'm just throwing this out. Might say, well, maybe they're not holding him responsible as much for the economy, the economic disaster, as they are maybe the governors. And, you know, we'll see if that tends to take place. You and I'll continue to track that as we go along. And it's fascinating stuff, my friend. And I appreciate you joining us this morning. Always good to have you aboard. We're not going to be with you next week, because we're going to be out of here on vacation, but we'll be back the following week.
Enjoy.
I'm going to give it a try. Terry Madonna here on WSBA Morning News with Gary Sutton. We'll